Hello, I'm Arnold Roosch from Markware, and in this short movie I would like to address some problems you might encounter when you work with Quark, InDesign, Illustrator, or any other application in which you are able to use colors. Let's dive in! When we open the ground control section of FlightCheck, the first thing we see is the 8 tabs. For now we only use the colors and images tabs, because they contain the most rules for the colors. As you can see, there are quite some rules here, but let's go over them one by one so you exactly know which one to use whenever you need them. First one, non-CMYK pen tone. This means that it will check for colors like LAB, HKS, or any other color model that you used in your file. Unused spot colors. This is to keep a good overview on which colors are actually used in your document. If FlightCheck finds unused spot colors, it means you can throw them away from your document without any problems. Use a spot color. This is a quick way to check if your spot color is used, especially when the document should be CMYK. Unnamed spot colors. This is to find colors that have no name and could mess up the handling of your plates. In order to keep it as simple as possible for your printer, it is advised that you give every plate a right name, every color a right name, so no confusion will occur. Non-default trap. This rule will flag if special trapping is set by the customer. Even though most of the time this rule will be overruled by the RIP station, it is wise to follow up on this because it might have something to do with the special wishes of the customer. Bitmap frames. This sometimes messes up the quality of the frame and is mostly used by Quark documents. Mismatched colors. This rule will flag when colors with the same name occur but with different color values. Mismatched spot process colors. These are colors with the same name but different color types, like CMYK and RGB. Similar name spot color. This rule will flag when two or more spot colors have the same name. Blend gradient. Some blends or gradients will give problems in the RIP station. You better be aware of this before it goes in. Patterns. The same goes here as goes for the blend gradient. It's better to know that it's in there before you get any problems in your RIP station. Hairlines. When working with computer to film, you don't want the lines to be too thin, for they will be gone by the time you get to plate. Note that you can adjust the width of the hairlines. Transparencies. If transparencies are found, this rule will flag and will give you the opportunity to make the proper adjustments. CMYK too high. This is to make sure all ink on the paper will dry once it's printed. When too much ink is printed on the paper, the ink will need a long time before it dries. With this rule, you can make sure that the CMYK value is below the percentage that you give in here. Same goes for CMYK too low. If you want all elements to be visible, below certain percentage, and depending if you are using film or not, you want to avoid elements getting lost. Where the color tab had to do with the document itself, we now have a look at the images tab, which has to do with all the images that are used in the document. Let's go to the column mode. In this mode section, you will find all the image modes that are available and that you might or might not want in your document. By checking or unchecking them or setting them to a warning or an error, you can make sure that no surprises occur once you put your file into the output device. In the contents column, there are only a few rules that we want to mention, like the ICC profile. The use of ICC profiles and color management will influence the quality of the print, so you better be aware that it is used. And if you are not using very defined color management, this might give you some problems. Ink density too high. This is like the check that we had for the document a while ago, but now applied for the image itself. With this movie, I've shown you just how important it is to check colors of every document that runs through your workflow. A thorough check with the number one preflight application, FlightCheck, assures the quality of colors and prevents wasted time and money spent on reprints because of the color was just not what everybody thought it would be. And with FlightCheck 6.5, supporting Quark 8 and Adobe CS4 on top of all the other applications we support just around the corner, it will only get better and easier. Just have a look at our website at www.marksware.com to read more about our great products and download a demo of FlightCheck Professional or Designer. You'll be surprised by the time and money you will be able to save. This is Arnold Roosch from Marksware, signing off.